Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Coon Rapids Ice Center for CTN's live coverage of girls high school hockey. Tonight, the Coon Rapids Cardinals host the Elk River Elks. Show you on Howie Shapiro up above, and Howie, an emotional night for this Coon Rapids squad as they retired the number of former captain Rachel Bonham.
A very cool experience for everybody here, and certainly for you and I as well, because we watched her play hockey here, and we'll see if some of that excitement and atmosphere can carry over to the ice for the Cardinals.
Well, they are going to need everything to get behind them because a very tough opponent on the other side of the ice, the Elk River Elks, 10-2 on the season, riding a six-game winning streak.
Yeah, they're a very, very good team, very, very quick team, and they're going to come in here and try and use their speed. You know, one of the players for the Elk River Elks, Abby Canton, she's the leading scorer, 12 goals, 11 assists. 12 goals in 12 games, that's pretty impressive, and she's one of a number of players that can put the puck in the net. And the Cardinals defensively, because they have been playing a little sloppy in their D-zone as of late, going to have to really do a good job of containing.
Well, really good depth on this Elk River squad. They have four girls averaging at least a 1 point a game. They have four more that have at least 10 points through that first 12 games. On the other side, the Cardinals are going to have to be strong on defense. Heidi Hanula has been a leader for this team on the blue line for several years, and they need her to help slow down that Elk River speed and depth.
Well, Heidi definitely has been a leader on this team, and she scores as well, playing from that defensive position. As Coach Christofferson told me, the number one key for this game tonight is we have to play solid on defense because they can score the puck. They're really good at putting the puck in the net, and we have to limit what they do.
Well, the Cardinals at 7-6, but they have outshot their opponent in many of their losses. They feel their record should be a little bit better. They hope to take a bite out of the Elks here tonight. The Cardinals and the Elks take the ice next on CTN.
When you watch CTN News, you'll notice we're different. It's about the people, the places, the stories that affect your life.
We're local. We focus on the local communities, the local issues, and the local stories.
They're the stories that impact you, the stories you won't find anywhere else.
It's the people, the places, and the events that make CTN so interesting.
It's about connecting you to your community, one story at a time.
Back at the Coon Rapids Ice Center, just about ready to drop the puck between the Cardinals and the Elks. Both teams looking for a fast start. And you look at the records, the Elks definitely the favored squad. But the Cardinals have been scrappy. We talked about it. They've lost a lot of games where they've outshot their opponents and losing close games.
Yeah, they really have. And, you know, with the record of 7-6, as you talked about it, some games where they came out on the wrong end of the scorecard, but they should have, they played like they should have won those games. So as this season continues to progress, Coach Christofferson said when I spoke to her yesterday, you know, she really likes the way this team is playing and really likes kind of their hitting kind of a stride at this point.
The look at the starting lineups, Annie Dalton between Haley Williams and Brianna Simon for the Elks, Bazal and Westgaard on the points, Tiffany LaFontaine in the net. For the Cardinals, Stahlberger centering Hackett and Del Castillo, Hanula and Bloomquist on the blue line, and Brittany Buell between the pipes. Cardinals push the puck into the Elk end, play it around to the far side, turned around by Bazal. She's tied up there in the corner. Cardinals trying to play it back out front, but Hackett couldn't get the angle on the puck. Recovered near side by Haley Williams, played ahead, and racing into the zone as Simon gets to her backhand, the save made by Brittany Buell. Speed to get in alone.
Buell's going to have to make saves like that and just make sure she covers up the puck. But you said it, speed, and that's the one thing that one of the things that Elk River possesses, and they're tonight going to try and use their speed to get to Buell early.
Hanson trying to play it off the far boards, kept in at the blue line by Madison Bazal. Near corner, Haley Williams plays it along as Hanula had lost her stick, but the Cardinals able to play it to center. Fish will dump it in and get a partial line change, and apparently did not gain the red line first, and that'll be icing.
So they'll bring that faceoff back in the Cardinal end again. Couldn't get the opportunity to not ice that puck, so it's going to be to the left of Buell as the faceoff.
Faceoff won by the Elks. The shot for the point by Gallus deflected into the corner. Bouncing around, hops over the stick of the defender and out to center ice. Tracking it down is Gallus. She's pressured. Leaves it along the boards. Unable to scoop it up was Stahlberger, or Greg rather, played back in deep. Good quick movement cross ice. Julia Miller will collect it off the boards. Not a lot on that shot. Trickles wide. Scooped up by Brina. She can't get it out and now does. And does not. Held in nicely there by Samantha Westgaard. Panula fans on the attempt to clear behind the net. Stahlberger kept it from getting out front. Brina will scoop it ahead to Lily Hackett. Hackett into the zone against Westgaard. Will just shoot through her. Saved easily by LaFontaine into the corner. Hackett recovers. Out to the point for Hanula. Knocked down with a glove by Brina. Tried to play it out front. Fired all the way down and right on net by Canton. Buell a long pass to Hanula near her own blue line. Hanula trying to go cross ice. It was partially deflected. Fish collects and takes it into the zone. Poked at by Westgaard. Hooked off the puck a little by Shea McClain. And Westgaard recovers for the Elks. Pass is deflected, makes it to center. Now skips away from Springman, and she tracks into the corner, chased by Lawrence. Behind the net, Lawrence turned around, and the puck was right behind her. Played back in behind. Nice job by Emily Fish to tie up. Get it to Lawrence with a little bit of room, played up to the near side. Ryan can't get it out. Blomqvist will fire at the length. That'll be icing. And we'll have a face-off back in the Coon Rapids end. 14-14 remaining in the first period.
Yeah, Cardinals, you know, Noel coming in, they're playing Elk River, a 10-2 team. There's only the two losses that Elk River has had this season is the opener to Eden Prairie. They lost 4-1, and then a 2-1 loss to Maple Grove. Otherwise, they've played really well this season. And the Cardinals, again, are going to try and see if maybe they can get on the board first. I think that would be big for them.
Dexheimer's shot was blocked by Del Castillo, pushed out of the zone by Stahlberger. Hansen will play it in, played right back out along the boards by Gallus. Icing waved off. First one there is Shea McClain. McClain will leave it in the corner. Trying to cycle a little bit there with Riley Springman. Played back behind. Lawrence there for the Cardinals. Ahead for Brina. Del Castillo just plays it away from pressure, gets it into the Elk end. Recovering it is Dexheimer, plays it behind the net for Allie Gallus. Long pass ahead, skips off of the stick of Shea McClain, turned around by the Cardinal defense, and the Cardinals are in offside. Bouncing puck just in front of the blue line, forced that one.
You know, that one of the keys, too, we talked about for the Elks, you look at their bench, they have a lot of depth, and that's one thing the Coon Rapids does not have. We talked about that in the game.
The clock has been running during an announcement. I mean, yeah. I don't think it, extra 10 seconds in a tie game in the first period, I don't think it really matters, but referee said, I think we should go back over there and straighten that out.
Well, the official goes and talks to both the scorekeeper and then now both, well, just the Coon Rapids bench. They did. They put, I believe they put 8 seconds back on.
Off the draw, got to Greg. She got it in. Opportunity trying to spring Haley Williams. Hanula will turn it around. Coming back up the far boards is Koronik. And she'll play it in. Hanula, first one there in the corner. Up the boards for Greg. Skips away from her. Koronik is shot in a glove save by Buell. Brianna Simon, excuse me, with the shot.
Elk River does a good job of being around the net. You saw the shot in on goal on Buell, but she just has to hang on and force that face off to her right.
Kept in at the blue line by Kennedy Mitchell. Hanula looking cross ice. Tried to get it to Bailey Ryan, but that was broken up by Madison Bazal. Cardinals able to force it into the zone. Mitchell recovers. Pressured by Hackett. Takes it behind her own net. Long pass, deflected, turned back in by Hanula and touched up offside by Lily Hackett.
So far, not a lot of action for either keeper. Two shots on goal for the Elks, just one so far for Coon Rapids. 12:34 remaining in the open period.
Off the draw, it comes back to Lawrence. She tried to play it into the zone, not a lot on it. Dexheimer gets it back toward the Coon Rapids end. Stahlberger tied up along the backboards by Haley Williams. Puck pushed along the near side. Trying to dig for it is Brina. Forced back into the corner by Dexheimer. Behind the net, Lawrence to Del Castillo. Off the boards, played out, and here's going to be your first penalty of the game as Annie Dalton bumped Stahlberger to the ice, and the Cardinals will have a power play.
Yeah, a little bit physical play here. You see Dalton's going to get a little too physical there, sending the Cardinal to the corner or to the board. So Coon Rapids now with the opportunity on the power play, see if they can get something cooking.
Off the faceoff, back to Hanula. Hackett tried to get it back to her, broken up and played all the way down by Abby Canton. Buell will sweep it behind the net. Hanula was pressured by Canton, and Canton nearly came away with the puck. That puck bounces away from Del Castillo, and now tied up along the boards. Canton pokes it free, and now carries deep into the corner. Canton behind the net. Play it out to the point, a quick shot that's blocked. And here comes Hackett leading the rush for the Cardinals the other way. Flips it in, poked to the corner. Fired around to the far side. Hansen can't stop it up. Stahlberger will play it back to Hanula near her own blue line. Hansen had it skip off her stick. Hackett races to recover. She's pressured along the boards by Shea McClain. Hackett sweeps it to Brina Del Castillo. Hacked at. Back to Fish. Fish bumped off it. Back to the point. Blomqvist got behind Fish. Marina to Fish. Trying to get it back out to the point. Good job by McClain breaking things up. Keeping pressure on. 43 seconds remaining on the power play. Del Castillo down in the corner. Blomqvist. Trying to create, lost the handle. Puck comes free, tipped out to center. Shea McClain will just play it in deep.
Oh, the Elks did a nice job on their penalty kill, just keeping that puck wide. Coon Rapids not an opportunity to get a shot on goal so far in this power play.
Only 15 seconds remaining. And the Cardinals just unable to accept a pass so far early in this first period. Pucks bouncing off of their sticks. Lawrence will take the shot on goal. And it is covered up by LaFontaine as the penalty expires.
Well, not much threat there from Coon Rapids on their first power play of this contest. And as you mentioned, you said the Cardinals having a little difficulty completing passes the way they want to.
Lawrence's shot, that went off of the skate of Andy Dalton out front. Cardinals recover behind the net. Bailey Ryan plays it back behind. Greg can't get to it. Coming out of the corner with it is Bizzal. Long pass and a race for it as Brianna Simon gets in deep. A shot. Buell makes the save and Hansen clears it away.
A nice job by Simon just to get an opportunity for herself and put the shot on net. Buell able to come up with that save.
Dalton from the slot, shot deflected up and over the cage. That was a dangerous one as it changed direction and Buell was out of position. Behind the net, Lawrence will recover for the Cardinals. Good pressure from Black. Turnaround shot attempt by Williams is blocked. And here comes Hansen skating to center. Hansen will play it off the boards in deep. Coon Rapids getting a line change as LaFontaine stops it up behind her own net. Hackett forcing the action. A turnover. Del Castillo had that one get away from her a little bit. Not a lot on that shot. A relatively easy save for Tiffany LaFontaine.
Well, you can see a little bit of the Cardinals getting a little bit of trouble down in there, and this is going to be a shot on net. But defensively, Elk River doing a good job of trying to control that puck down in the Cardinal end. And
behind the net goes Westgaard. Too much on that pass, and this will be icing. And we'll have a face-off back in the Elk River end. 8:46 remaining in this first period. No score and no real great scoring opportunities either way.
Either way, you know, three shots on goal for Elk River and just two for the Cardinals. But as these as this game unfolds, both teams are going to look for some better chances.
Off the draw, not enough on it to get around to the offensive player. Hackett tried to play it out front, went off a defender's foot and recovered by the Elks. Cross ice pass got away a little bit from Canton. She recovers and now plays it in deep. Down deep is Bozer, and here comes a penalty against Coon Rapids. Their first of the game, as Bloomquist is going to go for the check.
Another big test for Coon Rapids now on the penalty kill, as Elk River, who definitely has been enjoying putting the puck in the net this season, will be a test for Coon Rapids.
Elks able to control off the draw and will set up on the far side. Abby Canton top of the circles, up top for Mitchell, lost the handle and it gets out of the zone. Pressured by Stahlberger, gets it back for Bazal. Bazal will skate into the zone, leave it off. That pass was read well by Ryan, but can't clear as it's kept in at the line by Mitchell. Behind the net is Simon. Out to Bazal, top of the circle. Mitchell over for Canton. Down low, gets it back. Has to skate to recover. Canton down low, tried a little give and go. It deflected in on Buell, but fortunately she was in position. Simon carrying down low. Knocked off her stick by Hansen. Hansen able to break up that pass, and Bailey Ryan plays at the distance. Midway through this Elk River power play, and the Elks have had a chance to set up in the zone, but no opportunity to get the puck toward the net.
Well, good job that time by Coon Rapids, keeping that puck wide and then sending it down the length of the ice to take a little pressure out of their end.
Well, and here's Brina Del Castillo trying to pressure shorthanded. She's got loads of speed and can be dangerous if teams underestimate that speed. Here's
Absolutely.
Hackett now pressuring behind the net. Mitchell coughed it up a little bit. Hackett will slow things down along the boards. Del Castillo in to help out. Bazal able to get it across to Abby Canton. Canton into the zone, turns away from the pressure, plays it across in front. No black jerseys there as they were in the midst of a partial line change, and Hackett able to chop it back out to center. Simon kicking it ahead. Cardinals able to push it back out, back at the Elk River blue line. Gallus pass tipped away from Williams, and the Cardinals are back to full strength.
Well, good job penalty kill unit for Coon Rapids killing that one off.
Bouncing puck comes free. Hanula will play it off the near boards. Fish reads that pass and picks it off. Battling on the far side with Koretic. Able to come away with it is Whitney Gregg. Her shot is blocked. Stays with it, spinning in the corner. She was kind of tied up a little bit. Shot missed well wide. Kept in near side by Lawrence. Lawrence's shot through traffic, deflected wide. Ryan tracks it down, turning shot, deflected wide again behind the net. Gregg bumped off it, pressured. In to help is Fish. She'll come away with the puck for the Cardinals. Plays it in deep. And Ryan tripped up in front of the net, unable to get to it. Allie Gallus will control for the Elks. Cross ice pass. Lawrence tried to break it up, missed. Fortunately, in the skates of Shay McLean, and she was unable to get in on that breakaway. That one deflected up over the glass, out of play. And we'll have a faceoff in the Elk River end with 5:12 to play.
Yeah,
in the first, still looking for that first goal.
Sorry, Joe. Yeah, that would have been dangerous had McLean able to control that puck, because she would have had a clear path to the goaltender. There's head coach Jessica Christofferson in her fifth season behind the bench for Coon Rapids.
Off the faceoff, Hackett will dump it back into the corner. Del Castillo there waiting for it. Plays it out to the point for Lawrence. Lawrence's shot, that stopped up out front. Elk River clears it the length. That'll be icing. We're going to go back down to the Elk River end and try it again.
See, a little under 5 minutes remaining in the contest, and Coon Rapids now trying to put a little pressure down in the Elk end. You know, we talked about Elk River propensity to score goals. 52 goals on the season, the most in the conference.
Well, just four shots so far in this game, and really none of those four shots good scoring chances. as Coon Rapids has done a pretty good job of slowing their pace. Samantha Westgaard to center, poked away by Hanula. Recovered along the boards by Bazal. Nice skate move out back out to the point. Canton's shot misses wide. That's Annie Canton. You got two Cantons and two Westgaards on the team. Abby Canton, number 10. Annie Canton, number 40. The Westgaards are Samantha, number 20. And Drea, number 15. One can only assume all sisters.
You would assume so.
Not the most common last names. Lawrence in a battle there, coughed up the puck to Julia Miller. Played back behind for Abby Kent. She's tied up by Emily Fish, able to maintain control. Tried to play it off the net to herself. Fish able to get between Canton and the puck. Get it ahead to Bailey Ryan. That's not going to get out of the zone. Miller's shot knocks Fish's stick out of her hand. Puck is recovered by Greg. She's bumped off the puck and slow to get up as that one caught her right in the midsection. May have knocked the wind out of her a little bit.
Yeah, she went down. She looks like she's definitely in some discomfort.
Athletic trainer Jim Diffley out to take a look. There wasn't a ton of speed involved, but it did look like it came right in the midsection.
Oh, yeah, she took a hit to the midsection.
I don't know if she got a stick in there. Hopefully it's nothing more than having the wind knocked out of her.
Well, let's hope so.
But it was a case of two girls going for the puck and colliding more than one trying to deliver a body blow, so no call on the collision.
No intent on either part, obviously. There you see head coach Dale Sager behind the bench for the Elks, his first season as the head coach in Elk River with Coach Den Rogers last year and also in Centennial, was an assistant with Elk River for many years as well.
He's been busy.
He has been
what
busy.
You're saying.
He has been busy.
Not
no
new
doubt.
To the game.
Well, how busy will we be on Monday night for sports night?
It'll be an interesting show this week, and then we're going to take a week off.
A little hiatus.
Because a busy day next Monday. A first, I think, in CTN history. Two games in one day.
It is two games in one
outside day. I will take back, we did some simulcast stuff of last year's girls hockey tournament that they did more than one game, but it will be certainly a first for you and I.
Yes, it will.
Going to do some boys basketball and some girls hockey.
Some girls hockey, I believe. Yes, correct.
We got a lot of girls hockey coming up.
We do.
Can we do them next Friday too?
No, next Friday is girls basketball.
Oh, it's girls basketball and South State ball.
Yep.
Okay.
Got to keep it all straight.
I'm really excited for that doubleheader on Monday because of the boys' basketball game. No offense to the girls' hockey team.
I know why.
But the opponent, I've been waiting for this a long time.
The Southwest, your alma mater.
The
Southwest,
Lakers.
The Lakers. And nobody will know that you went to school there from that school now. But
we'll have
to let them know.
No.
We'll have to let them know. Joe Young, graduate of Southwest High.
Hackett able to tip this one out to center, leading down the right wing. Her shot deflected wide. Brina will play it back to the point. Bloomquist will keep it in. Del Castillo down below for Hackett. Tried to get it back to her. It was kicked away and recovered by Haley Williams. Williams races in and just pokes it into the zone. Push back out, a tie up along the boards with Abby Canton and Lily Hackett. Puck kick back to the near side. Bloomquist will get it in deep. LaFontaine leaving it there behind her net for Gallus. And Gallus skates away from a poke check. And that one is tipped, so no icing. Tip back to the far side. Ryan can't get it past Williams, or Simon rather. And Westgaard is going to pick up the penalty as she took.
Yeah, not a smart. Not a smart penalty in that situation.
It's a good idea to put some body pressure on. But she leaned into her a little too much, put Bailey Ryan on the ice. And the Cardinals will go back on the power play with just 2:13 remaining in the period.
You're going to see the infraction right here. Just a little bit too much body. And we'll see if Coon Rapids can convert on their second opportunity.
Well, unable to do much on that first power play. One shot right in the final second of the power play, and there wasn't a lot on it. Instead, off the faceoff, it's Elk River creating a two-on-one. The pass a little too far for Simon. Cardinals regroup center ice. Cross ice pass. Alyssa Hansen will carry it into the zone on the far side and try and set up in the corner.
Well, Hansen had a couple of goals in that 6-2 win over Rogers the other night.
Hansen able to stop it up, keep it in at the blue line. Del Castillo back to the point. Hansen shoots. LaFontaine kicks it to the corner. Trying to float Simon and just send a long pass to her, but that was broken up. Panula's shot is blocked. Hackett had it tipped off her stick. Recovered by Mitchell. And she's able to get it out to center. Canton swings and misses at it. Del Castillo off the boards for Hackett. Hackett into the zone, leaves it off for Stahlberger. She got tripped up, just sent it toward the net. Recovered by Bazal. Long pass to Simon. Slowed down, got it back across to Canton. Her shot right into the breadbasket of Brittany Buell.
Again, not a lot of offense for Coon Rapids on this power play opportunity with 33 seconds remaining. And Elk River comes back shorthanded and gets a shot on net, forcing the face off to the right of Brittany Buell. Oh, to the left, sorry. The other right.
All right. Bailey Ryan skating into the zone for the Cardinals. We'll take it behind the net. Tried to leave it off. Broken up there by Dexheimer. Poked out by Abby Canton. Hanula. Pressured by Canton. And that one gets away from Bloomquist. Now set all the way down. And Buell will stop it up behind her own net. Just one shot on goal for that power play again. Here comes Westgaard, fresh out of the zone. Gets into a good spot, shoots, turned away by Buell. Buzzer will sound and we will go to the first intermission with no score.
Well, I think Cardinals have to be fairly pleased with that period. They're able to come away without a goal scored against. Like to have a little more offensive production, I'm sure.
Well, we will take a break and then we will find out how Coach Christofferson felt about that first period. We'll interview her next on Sportsnet.
Live with a human for a while and you get to know a few things. Like, I know she's actually not a morning person. I know she does strange tricks for no treats. I know that water makes her howl like crazy. I even know how the floors stay so clean. She's quick. But the one thing I will never for the life of me know is how she gets so tiny and inside that box. Natalie, how do you get so tiny?
Hey, you going out like that?
Yeah, why?
Well, what would the neighbors think?
I see. Come look at Mr. Feather.
Look what I have.
Mr. Bird, remember? Bark, bark, bark. We're just playing. I'm trying to get you out of here.
Even still.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Back at the Coon Rapids Ice Center. No score between Coon Rapids and Elk River after the first period of play. We're joined now by Coach Christofferson, and Coach, your thoughts on that first period?
You know, I think it's pretty obvious their game plan is to try to out-physical us, which, you know, with the way we work and kind of the way that's getting around the league, I'd say that's probably a good idea on their part. But, you know, I thought we outskated them a little bit, weathered the storm, whatever you want to call it, at first. And then, you know, we've just had too many opportunities, and we're playing way too sloppy. We're not a lot of poise right now.
They're a fast team, and I thought you guys did a nice job of kind of slowing them down a little bit. You know, six shots on goal. I could imagine, though, offensively, you guys need a little more output in front of their net.
Oh, certainly. I don't I'm not quite in favor of the way the shots are being counted right now, but that's irrelevant nonetheless. You know, we haven't gotten the grade A chances that we're going to need if we're going to win this game. But, you know, on the power play, we've had two opportunities now, and we're not moving the puck. We're trying to stick handle. We're doing all those things that, you know, we preach. Just make the easy pass, get to the net, stuff like that. And we're just, I don't know, we're playing a little bit rattled right now.
Well, and that's how what I was going to ask you about. It looks as if there's maybe a little bit of nerves in your girls having trouble accepting passes and kind of thinking too much. What do you do to try and turn that around in the second period?
Well, you know, we were a little bit like this against Blaine, too. They're physical, and we don't have any time and space right now, and we've had a hard time adjusting to that in the first period. I think, you know, when I say we weathered the storm, I think we hung in there and we took it. But, you know, we have to find a way to take it to them now. And I don't think they play great team defense in their own end. So we'd like to obviously try to keep the puck down there and make some things happen. I thought we had a nice shot from the point that almost got through. That's the way we're going to score goals against a team like this. And then, you know, we need to limit their opportunities, obviously, and not let them enter the zone with speed.
All right, well, thank you for joining us. Good luck in the second period. We'll take a break, and we will be back with more girls hockey action next on CTF.
Body language can tell you all sorts of things. Like someone is having a stroke. Know the sudden signs. Learn fast. Face drooping. Arm weakness. Speech difficulty. Time to call 911 and get them to a hospital immediately. Learn the body language and spot a stroke fast.
Are you getting this, honey?
Oh, prime time. We are rolling.
All right, Mama's gonna bring it home. Mama's gonna bring it home.
Okay.
Come on, watch this guy.
Oh, backwards.
Oh, don't. Oh.
It went into Bob and Carol's yard.
Oh, no.
Okay,
here it goes.
Oh, Mom!
Challenge your kids to be active and eat healthy.
Yeah, all right, let's see what you can do. Let's go.
They might surprise you.
Let's go.
Search We Can for more ideas on how you and your kids can get healthy together.
At the Coon Rapids Ice Centers. We talked a little bit about a special evening here at the Ice Center as the Cardinals, for the first time ever, retiring a high school jersey for that young lady right there, Rachel Bonnet. Number 7, a tremendous part of the state championship team here a few years ago. And with more on that ceremony, let's take a look.
.270 career points, 3-time captain, 5-time all-conference, all-metro, all-state, Athena Award winner, and Miss Hockey finalist here at Coon Rapids High School. At the University of Minnesota, 120 career points and counting, team captain, all-WCHA, all-USDHO, and a Patty Kazmaier Award top 10 finalist. Easily one of, if not the best athlete to ever come through our community. Please direct your attention to the screen behind the bench for a short video. So many memories, so many goals, so many highlights and celebrations that we got to have. Could go on and on about your ability and your talent. You were and are one of the best to ever play at this level. The things that take your value to an entirely different level are not things. From the moment that you told me, we don't want a new coach, I knew that I had a leader on my hands. You set the bar for what commitment and loyalty should look like. You were arguably the best player in the state that year, and it was never about you, it was about the team. When we came into the locker room before the third place game of the state tournament, you guys were all crying. That's when it hit me. Your dreams, the goals, the wins, they were all secondary to the team. And this day signaled the end of the team. What a special moment and reminder of what really matters and the values that you instilled in those girls. Since then, you have continued to exceed everyone's expectations. You have always loved proving people wrong. You found yourself as one of the best players on the best team in the nation and have accomplished incredible things as a student athlete. You've continued to lead with character and value, undoubtedly making your list of team and individual accomplishments even more impressive. Last but not least, our community has remained a priority to you. The girls and boys that play here all know you, not because of how many goals you scored, but because you show them that they are important to you. Thank you for being such an incredible representative of Coon Rapids, Coon Rapids High School, and everything, anyone and everything in this community. We are so honored to have you forever represent our program. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the far end of the arena. For the first time, we will retire a player number, forever noting your place in our program's history. Congratulations, Rachel. Your impact on our community has been immeasurable.
And there it is, a special momentum of her time here. Her number 7 sweater and smiles on her and the audience's faces so far through the first period. As you get a better look at the banner, 2006 to 2011, a member of the Coon Rapids Cardinal varsity hockey team, played with the USA under 18 team in 2010. And since then, a member of the 2-time national champion Minnesota Gophers.
Yeah, what a great evening for her and her family and for everybody in Coon Rapids, because she's left an indelible mark on this program and one that other young women can look to and follow and hope to emulate.
Well, I remember Rachel as far back as 7th and 8th grade when she first joined the team. And just this little kid excited to get in front of the camera and see her on herself when we had a camera and monitor set up in the corner where we used to do the interviews. And just liked seeing herself on camera, just being a kid. But then being so impressed by the way she played, even at that young age. And then just to watch her throughout her career, I still to this day say, the most dominant player I have ever had the privilege of watching in a Coon Rapids uniform.
I totally agree. And you know, anytime she had the puck and an opportunity to score, she is so dangerous. And
well, time she had a puck, she had the opportunity to score.
Yeah, every time she had an opportunity to score, though, she you could almost count on the fact that she was going to put in, especially that senior year. She had such a huge year, and it was so much fun for us and to be a small part of it. And very well recognized award for her, and the fact that they put this banner up, it says a lot about that young lady.
And with that, we will take another short break. We'll be back with first period stats and highlights after this. You're watching live girls high school hockey on CTN.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Why are you stabbing me with it?
No,
they want to help, but don't know how. Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
All right, this spot. My motto, safety first.
Back at the Coon Rapids Ice Center, just about ready to drop the puck on the second period. We're going to skip the stats and highlights because we didn't have a whole lot of highlights. And I'll tell you, the Elks outshot the Cardinals 6-3. Both teams were 0-for on the power play. The Elks 0-for-1, the Cardinals 0-for-2. Each team getting one shot on goal per power play attempt, which is, needless to say, not the kind of production either wanted. But getting underway, we got an early icing against the Cardinals. And now I'd like to welcome to our broadcast and thank for being with us, Rachel Bonna.
Thanks for having me. I'm glad to be back.
Well, it's great to have you back, and it's really special for you to share in this with us because of all the memories you brought to us while you were playing on this Coon Rapids team. Real, very exciting and well-deserved honor for you.
Yeah, it was exciting to watch that video and hear you guys commentating a few of the goals.
We heard mostly Joe, and that's the way he likes it. So,
it's still not enough for my liking. I could pretty much put a whole resume tape together for myself with the goals. I was privileged enough to see you score. Looking back on it, obviously, you've had a magnificent career at the collegiate level. What do you remember most, and what are your fondest memories of the high school experience?
Oh, I have a few. I got asked this question not too long ago, and it sparked my memory of a couple. Obviously, my senior year was a year to remember, I think, for everyone and for the program as a whole, just winning the section championship, going to state, getting third there. But one I remember, too, pretty fondly that I'm sure you guys do is my ninth grade year in sections when we were the seventh seed and Blaine was the second and we beat them in overtime. That was one of my favorite memories, too.
Yeah, a big upset against a big rival in an important game.
Yeah, and then we ended up making it to the section championship as the seventh seed, which doesn't happen too often. So that was a special year, too.
You know, one of the coolest things I think is that, you know, the success you've had and for the young girls in this community to look up to you and say, this is possible, this is what I can do. That has to make you feel so good.
Yeah, that's really cool to see. And obviously I had people to look up to as I was coming up in this program. And so to be that girl for all of them is a pretty special thing.
Well, and I think something that may be overlooked a lot, you know, so often you hear people talk about, oh, it's natural talent. And I know from watching what you did off the ice that you worked really, really hard to get to where you were.
Yeah, and I think that's kind of the key. There's a lot of players who, you know, have natural talent and stuff, but just to get to the next level, it does take a lot of off-ice work. And obviously Rob Potter and then Jess my last year put us through some pretty good dry land and all that stuff, and we were always around the rink. So, yeah, I think that plays a really important part.
Opportunity for the Cardinals. A tip shot just misses wide. But and then you go on to obviously receive some magnificent coaching at the collegiate level, mm-hmm. and some wonderful experiences. You got this one final season. Your thoughts on wrapping up the U of M career?
It's crazy. I mean, I feel like I just wrapped up my Cardinal career, and now I have to wrap up my Gopher career, and that's going to be the end of it for me. And it's really sad to think about. But like you said, I've had great opportunities. I've had success, and it's just been a great playing career for myself.
Well, and you say that'll be it. No more trying out for the U.S. team?
No. I declined their offer this winter just because, I don't know, that's kind of been a tough road for me, and I've just kind of decided it's not really what I want, and I wouldn't want to take away from someone who, you know, wants to continue playing and wants to try out for that next Olympic team. I think that's kind of too far in the future for me, and so I'm just kind of ready to give it up after college.
Well, when you look back at everything you've accomplished, it's got to be so self-satisfying for you to say, this is how hard I've worked and this is where I've come. And what a big decision for you to say, this will be it for me in terms of the competitive hockey like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I mean, it's easy to say now, but I know at the end of my season this year, it's going to be hard to, you know, put on the jersey one last time and play in one last game. I think I'm such a competitive person. I think I'll just need to find something else to compete with.
Well, wait. 1 year and find out just how much you miss it after a year.
Oh, I know.
Opportunity out front and a goal. Shea McLean left alone on the doorstep. A good feed from behind the net. And the Elk River Elks score the first goal.
And, you know, again, they're so dangerous that you give them an opportunity like that in front of the net. And it's tough for Brittany Buell to make that stop. And Elk River's going to get the first goal of the game and jump out on top.
Nice feed from Williams. And a one-timer through the five hole for Shea McLean.
Yeah, tough one there.
It is a tough one. It is a tough one.
Now moving forward, you're gonna hang up the blades at least competitively. What does the future hold for Rachel Bob?
Well, I've kind of had a change of plans of many times throughout college, which I think
that
is
never
a surprise. Yeah,
I think is pretty normal. And so
yes.
at this point in my life, I am trying to pursue a nursing nursing future. I'm graduating with a child psychology major, and then
Cardinals almost an opportunity to get it right back, but Hackett couldn't poke it home.
So I'm just going to try to go to nursing school when I graduate.
Oh, that's great. Yep. That's a wonderful thing to do. And, you know, we certainly wish you all the best. No
Thank
doubt.
Thank you.
Yes, it will be, you know, we've been here a long time, obviously.
Yeah.
Opportunity.
Really long time.
You didn't have to agree.
Awesome.
You didn't have to agree so quickly.
Not that long.
But
that long.
You know, in the time that we have been privileged enough to broadcast Coon Rapids Sports, you are definitely one of the highlights of our career.
Absolutely.
Here.
Just absolutely.
An absolute pleasure watching you play and being able to be a part of that.
Well, thank you. That's really nice to hear. I'm glad I could provide some good entertainment.
Absolutely.
Oh, there was
more than good. It was more than good. It was great.
During the intermission, when we were watching the presentation, I was talking about, I remember you as a seventh or eighth grader, very young, and we had the interview station set up over in the corner, and so there was just camera there with a monitor, and I remember you just loved seeing yourself on camera. And then that progressed to when you actually had to be on camera and do interviews. At first, when you were younger, you hated it.
Yep.
And then that was another part of your leadership role that I thought you took on very well, and you got used to it.
And you became very good at it.
Yeah. Very good.
Yeah, well, thank you. I've been working on the public speaking.
And now you're ready to take Howie's job.
Yeah.
Sure, why not?
Maybe,
absolutely.
Yeah, no.
You know, I'm getting old. To get to the point where maybe I'll
retire.
Nope,
putting
you guys
him
are
out
too
to,
good.
Him
out to pasture.
Pasture.
Yeah, out to pasture.
Yeah.
Oh. Cardinals hammering away and a goal. And we're right back to tie. Lily Hackett poking it home.
Boy, what a big
goal. It up 1-1.
What a big goal. We were talking about Elk River, the most goals in the conference, and, you know, averaging a little over four a game.
Wow.
And Coon Rapids, you know, knew that they were going to be in for a dogfight here, but able to come back and tie it up because the momentum had gone over to Elk River. Pretty big goal for the Cardinals.
That was a great goal. Glad I could see one.
Absolutely.
I loved it. I love the dirty goals.
Oh, yeah.
I do. You know, pretty goals are great, but
those
the scrappy
don't happen very often in college, I can tell you that.
Oh, I bet not.
Nope, you got to get the dirty ones.
And the scrappy ones mean you really worked for it.
Yeah, for sure. Oh, they gave it to Ryan. Jessica Lawrence.
Did I see it? Maybe I saw the number wrong.
Like, it did look like Hackett hit it too in front. But
well, you're getting old, Joe. Your eyes are maybe starting to fail you a little bit.
I may be old, but I'm not
as
old as
me.
You.
I know. I set myself up for every time I say that. But that's okay.
Either way, the Cardinals have evened the score. Ryan, a nice job there to poke that one out of the zone. And tracking it all the way back is Allie Gallus.
Well, I know, Rachel, that we're not the only people that you have to spend time with, so we really want to appreciate the fact that you came by, talked a little bit. And
absolutely.
And it's a big memory for us.
And best of luck the rest of this Gopher season. And
thank you.
Love to see you grab one more of those trophies
without
to end your career.
I think three out of four would be a nice way to end it.
Absolutely.
Yes,
absolutely.
Me.
Absolutely.
So I'll try my best.
All right.
Thanks for having me.
Oh, thanks for joining us.
Of course.
Good luck to you always.
Just a very special young lady and a great representative of Coon Rapids community and Coon Rapids hockey.
Yeah, it was great that she spent a little time with us. It made it special, with her evening and capping it off here.
If we go a while, if we have another scoring drought, maybe we need to bring her back.
Exactly.
You know, we did 17 minutes without her and no scoring.
Go back to a three-person booth.
She was here for 6 minutes of hockey, and we got two goals out of it.
Absolutely.
And despite the fact that I was engaging in the conversation, I was still right on it when both goals were scored.
That's because you're a true professional and don't let anybody ever tell you differently.
Let's not go too far. Sometimes I get lucky. This one played all the way down. That'll be icing. 9:15 to play in the second. We're all tied at a goal apiece.
Yeah, what a big goal for Coon Rapids to come back.
Maybe we should have Neil Hennon put on the headset.
Why not?
He's here. Rachel comes for 5 minutes and talks, and then Neil comes and takes his box away.
Takes the box away. Okay, we're done with that.
Got to hats off to our CTN crew. We have some of the finest technical crew here.
Absolutely.
And that is why that this CTN broadcasting team has been so successful over the years. We have received a number of awards from a number of different organizations. And while I would love to say, yeah, it's because I'm awesome, it's really because the people around us are fantastic.
Yeah, we're very fortunate in
that
respect.
What many people probably don't know about the CTN crew is a lot of our camera operators and technical folks, when they're not here, they're off doing the Wild. They're doing Twins,
Vikings.
Timberwolves,
yep.
Vikings.
Absolutely.
They're the best in the business in the Minnesota area.
Without a doubt. We're very fortunate to be able to work with them.
How a super that? Special throw out to Brian Trausch for making us sound as good as we do.
Even though he was a little late. We'll forgive him because he's so talented.
Scrum along the near side boards just inside the blue line. Buck comes free back to the Cardinal blue. Hanula hard off the far side. Got into the skates of Brina Del Castillo. Play back across to Williams into the slot. And a glove save for Brittany Buell.
You know, I heard a little blubbering coming from the truck, and it was Millington, because we didn't give him a shout out. What a great job you're doing tonight, Jeremy.
Jeremy Millington
production.
It's a production.
Good job, Jeremy.
Phenomenal.
How could we ever forget you? As much as we try.
It's just fun to give him a hard time. Dexheimer can't keep it in at the blue, and Hackett out races her for the puck, trying to get back across against Gallus and couldn't get the puck through. Dexheimer plays it back behind the net. And that one nearly bounced off of Dexheimer back into the net. That took a dangerous hop. Stahlberger will backhand it in deep. Dexheimer recovers, pressured there by Protas. Kept in at the blue line by Ryan. Ryan trying to jam it in. That one came loose and came across to the near side. And
well, Cardinals are doing
They had LaFontaine in a vulnerable position but couldn't capitalize.
They did, and they're doing a nice job of keeping the pressure down in the Elks.
This one end. Spun around to the near side. Lawrence trying to keep it away from Williams, or Simon rather. Simon has it poked off her stick by Hansen. And we're going to have a penalty. A little bit of frustration on the part of Brianna Simon after getting the puck poked off her stick.
Yeah, you know, that's something that that's a penalty she cannot take in a situation here. It's a 1-1 game, 6:35 remaining in the second. And we'll see the flurry in front
of
LaFontaine.
Oh, yep. It was Dalton that had bounced off. I thought it was Dexheimer had bounced off.
Well, Cardinals go back on the power play, their third opportunity here tonight.
Well, just one shot on each of the power plays in the first period. And just had trouble just moving it and finding a little bit of space. Now able to set up on the near side. Del Castillo shoots wide. Hanula recovers on the far board. Down low to Hackett. Into the corner for Stahlberger. Hackett back up top for Hanula. Walking in, a shot deflected and a save made. And there's going to be another penalty. That was just plain stupid,
yeah,
right there.
That was foolish.
You cannot do that.
Boy, somebody can get hurt on a situation
Madison
like
Bizzall
that.
Madison Bizzall just throwing Stahlberger to the ground, and that's going to put Coon Rapids up 5-on-3.
Yeah, and Coach Steger, I'm sure, is very frustrated by these two penalties, both of them,
and that is
were avoidable.
Yeah. I'm sure she saw it as trying to stand up for her goaltender, but it was after the whistle. Stahlberger was not going toward the net. And Cardinals with 1:34 of 5-on-3.
Two-minute reminder for Rockford, Castile, Rivers,
Alyssa Hansen has some trouble. Dalton able to steal it free and lead a rush that is deflected up. And then Dalton continues to pressure, and that's
going
to be
a penalty. They're coming back
against Hansen. On Hansen. And that's one she maybe had to take.
Well, you know, I think the fact that she wasn't sure if Buell was going to hang that puck or let it go, and she did let it go and almost gave up an opportunity in front of the net. You can see it right there coming back into your picture.
Well, I don't agree with the call. That,
yeah, I think she just...
They call her for a hook, so it'll be Coon Rapids a 4-on-3 for the next 1:16, and then we'll play 4-on-4 for about almost 30 seconds, and then it'll be about a 15-second power play for the Elks. 4-on-3, a lot of space on the ice out there. Lawrence, shot, misses wide. Out to the point. Across, Lawrence, shot, misses again. Should really hit the net from there.
Yeah.
Del Castillo to Hinula. Lawrence. Back to the point. Back to Lawrence, skipped off her stick. Down to Stahlberger in the corner. Out to Lawrence. Shot is blocked. Winding and firing is Hinula, and easy save for LaFontaine.
Shots on goal are now even 9 apiece. And I think the biggest thing for Elk River, you know, as far as we'll find out what Coach Sager has to say, but really lack of offensive production opportunity here in this second period. And in credit to Coon Rapids, they're doing a nice job of controlling the puck down in the Elks end.
Westgaard will skate this one through center to the blue line. That shot missing wide. Blomqvist will recover in the corner. Long pass, fresh off the bench is Canton to break it up. Kicked ahead. Westgaard will play it back into the zone. Blomqvist. Long pass for Hackett. Into the zone, and now it's a 4-on-4 for the next 25 seconds. Canton had trouble receiving that pass, bumped a little bit by Blomqvist, now gets it across to Miller, taken away from her by Hinula. Hinula will skate behind her own net, play it around Canton, kept in at the blue line by Gallus. Canton trying to get it out front to Miller. Miller recovers, puts it toward the net and scores. And that one, Buell just lost sight of it. That was hardly moving at all.
It wasn't, it looked like she may have, it was, looked like Canton was trying to camp out in front and she was tied up and didn't see where that puck was coming from, and it just slid past her. That's a tough goal to give up. See it again as it comes in short. Look at the tie up in front. Blomqvist and Canton. And that one will get by Brittany Buell and make it 2-1 in favor of Elk River. Well, the official is what they're talking about over
there. They're trying to figure out who scored it, because it was moving about
right. They're gonna give
2
it to
miles per hour.
McClain? No.
And the other is they want to make sure that it was indeed on the power play, as Simon had just gotten out of the box. Or not Simon, it was Bazal who had just gotten out of the box. So a power play goal.
That's another situation, Joe, where they really, I think, in this second period anyway, Coon Rapids out playing Elk River,
well, yeah,
but Elk River comes up with the goal.
On the power play at 12 minutes, 53 seconds, number 29, Julian Miller.
Julian Miller getting the goal. Stahlberger backhand! And a big save by LaFontaine.
Well, Stahlberger used her speed to gain the edge and then came right in front of LaFontaine and tried to flip it in, but give her credit, LaFontaine able to glove that puck for the save, forcing the faceoff to her left. She's going to get around the defense, try and backhand that in, and LaFontaine makes a nice save.
Wow, Elks floating two And Hanula breaks up the attempt. Try to wrap around. Bailey Ryan with it on the boards. Shot toward the net. LaFontaine saves and covers.
Well, Cardinals, again, doesn't look like that goal has taken anything out of them. They're working as hard as they were before that goal was scored.
Hanula didn't get a lot on that shot. It stopped up before it gets through to the net. Fish will play it back to Hanula again. Quick wrist shot deflected wide. Simon plays it off the boards and out to center ice. Haley Williams collects into the zone. A shot up high and over the net. Hanula skates through center into the zone. Sets up in the corner, fanned on the pass attempt, and the puck taken away. Poke behind the net. Recovered there by Mitchell. Taken away by Hackett. Hackett trying to turn and get it back in. Hanula will play it back in deep. Cardinals getting a bit of a line change. That pass deflected and broken up. Simon plays it into the zone. Lawrence recovers for Coon Rapids. Her pass deflected. And back into the zone goes Kennedy Mitchell. Mitchell plays it out front and Canton couldn't get it on the backhand.
That was a nice play because Canton was right there in front of the net without a defender.
Canton an opportunity, couldn't get much on the shot. Mitchell was tripped up by a stick, but Hansen wisely just let the stick go as soon as it got between the opponent's legs. Bouncing puck out front, cleared toward the board. Stahlberger will recover for Coon Rapids.
Well, Hansen broke her stick for Coon Rapids, had to get off the ice.
No, it just dropped it.
Oh, I thought the broke.
No, it was okay. Between the legs of Kennedy Mitchell. She just let it go to avoid getting called for a trip. Tried to pick it back up and then couldn't get the handle on it, so skated off. Unless she started to pick it up and realized it was broken, but I don't think that's the case.
I thought the way it was sitting on the ice, it looked to me like part of the front was broke, was chipped off, but.
Some of the paint, maybe.
Oh, the paint, yeah, the paint. I thought there was, it looked kind of a little bit of a smaller blade to me the way it was sitting on the ice.
The tape might have come off a little bit. Ooh, a nice tip out front. Buell able to make the save and cover it up.
Oh, she was fortunate there because you almost
lost the handle on it. The Elks bench was about half of them were up ready to celebrate. That one flipped into the Elk River bench. 1:04 remaining in this second period. Elk River holding on to a 2-1 lead.
Now Cardinals out shooting Elk River 12-1, according to the scoreboard.
12-11.
What did I say? 12-1. 12-11. Sorry.
Fish tips it ahead, broken up by the Elks in neutral ice. Played back into the zone, a nice steal, a shot, and a glove save by Brittany Buell. Samantha Westgaard had it taken away by Alyssa Hansen. Played around behind the net, Hackett. Can't get it past Mitchell. Played out to center by Fish and played right back in by Julia Miller. Miller with that go-ahead goal, and that's icing just under 20 seconds remaining. Miller maybe getting the slowest goal
ever
of her career.
Now she'll take it though. Goes in the back of the net, you'll take it no matter how it goes in.
Yeah, Buell just hoping her team can go out and get that one back for her. Ahead to Stahlberger, races into the zone, one on two. Gets in deep, that puck poked at by LaFontaine. Comes back around the near side. The buzzer will sound, and we will go to the second intermission. Elk River, a 2-1 lead on a weird goal. And we will talk to head coach Dale Sager right after this. You're watching live girls high school hockey on CTF.
This is the moment I knew. His future had no boundaries.
There are some moments only the forest can inspire. Find yours at discovertheforest.org.
The next 30 seconds can save you a lot of money. Just do your laundry in cold and stick to full loads. Auto-sleep your computers. Plug your gadgets in a power strip and switch it off when you're done. Head it out, turn back your thermostat by 10 degrees. And drive sensibly. The more energy you save, the more money you save. Find other great tips at energysaver.gov.
So what you want to do is, have you already enrolled?
You're doing fine.
What did that just do?
Select the drop-down menu again. Okay. Wait. You're already enrolled. Example here, so... Don't panic. You're ready to make your payments. There it is.
Oh my God!
I really can't believe it.
That's awesome.
Good for you.
Back at the Coon Rapids Ice Center, Elk River, a 2-1 lead after two periods. We're joined now by head coach Dale Sager. And coach, you got to be happy with the lead, although you get it on a weird goal.
We really did. And we talked after the first period about throwing the puck on net and just getting things in the net and crashing. And we did a nice job of having people in front of the net there, and it just snuck through for the go-ahead goal.
I know one of the things you talked to me about was using your team speed and trying to put some pressure on. I thought Coon Rapids did a nice job, especially in that second period of kind of eliminating some of that for you and putting a lot of pressure in on your end.
They really have. They've done a lot of things to slow us down and take us out of our game, and that's why it's such a close game right now. They're doing a great job, just chipping pucks and winning races, and Jess has them working really hard, and they're doing a good job over there.
Yeah, and that was going to lead right into my question. It seemed that they found a little more time to set up in your zone in that second period and kind of dictate the pace of the game. How do you get it turned around, especially protecting that one goal lead?
You know, I think we just need to get our enthusiasm up a little bit. We scored that goal, we got a little excited, but then we get back down. We need to just pick it up a little bit and, you know, get some enthusiasm, play a little higher level, and I hope we'll be all right. So.
All right, well, thanks for joining us, and best of luck in the third period. We'll take another break. We will be back with second period stats and highlights after this. You're watching live girls high school hockey on CTN.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
Bullying.
Why are you stabbing me with it?
No,
no.
They want to help,
ow,
but don't know how.
Oh, you got...
Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
There are a million places you'd never consider texting. So why would you do it while driving? Leave risky driving to the professionals. Stop the texts, and together we can stop the wrecks.
Jimmy can't sing,
and Tommy can't dance,
so we're gonna put some ants in their pants.
Aww. Kids will spend 22 minutes watching us, the super duper party troopers, sing about ants in their pants.
Isn't that funny? Ants in their pants, they've got ants in their pants, they've got ants in their pants.
Brushing for 2 minutes now can save your child from severe tooth pain later. 2 minutes twice a day. They have the time.
Every day across America, excess food is gathered by a network of good people at local food banks, giving hope to millions of children who struggle with hunger. They've earned their wings, and you can too. Together, we can solve child hunger. Support Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
Back at the Coon Rapids Ice Center, the Elks a 2-1 lead after two periods of play. And after a scoreless first, a couple of quick ones back-to-back early in that second period. And then as we talked about, the weird goal that gave the Elks the lead. A nice setup out front, buried by Shea McLean, 4:14 in. Gave Elk River the early 1-0 lead. The Cardinals answer about a minute and a half later, scrapping for a goal off of a faceoff. Shot comes from the point. Stahlberger, Hackett are there. They ended up giving this to Bailey Ryan, but it's Lily Hackett. I'm going to stand by my initial assessment of that, that it's Lily Hackett. The assist going to Stahlberger, and there's the weird one, just kind of a turnaround shot by Julia Miller with nothing on it, but it found the hole between the pads. Stahlberger nearly tying it on the backhand, but LaFontaine up to the challenge.
Well, you know, as well as the Cardinals have played in that second period, it's almost a shame that they gave up a goal like that to lose that lead. But, you know, I think they've been playing really well, out shooting the Elks 13-11. And, you know, Coach Sager mentioned that, you know, Coon Rapids doing a good job of taking the Elks out of their game plan. And I truly believe that Elk River felt that they would have quite possibly a little larger lead at this point. You know, we talked about winners of six in a row playing really well at 10-2. But Coon Rapids is giving Elk River everything that they can hope for and more.
Well, and the next goal is going to be critical. Who's going to score it? We'll find out when we return. Pucks drops on the third period next on CTN.
Look at me. Hey.
Raymond, look at Mommy.
Maybe the light hurts his eyes.
Maybe she's just not hungry.
Maybe he can't hear us.
Maybe we're not stimulating him enough. Maybe it's a phase.
Avoiding eye contact is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today. The sooner it's diagnosed, the better.
Back at the Coon Rapids Ice Center, just about ready to get this third period underway. Elk River holding on to the slimmest of leads at 2-1. But Coon Rapids has to have some confidence coming out of the locker room, knowing that they really had the better period in the second.
Well, yeah, and plus that goal that they gave up was, you know, a goal you don't see very often, just kind of slowly trickling through, and Buell didn't see it, and it got by her.
Elks win possession off the opening draw. Puck comes near side to Williams. Pass to Canton is broken up. Big collision. And Hackett ends up on the ice, but no call as there was no intent. Stopped up by Bazal along the boards. Hackett trying to play it back into the corner. Del Castillo hacking at it as well. Bazal continues to keep the pressure on the puck. Madison Bazal, a pretty impressive player, just a freshman, has definitely been around the puck a lot tonight.
Yep.
Shot by Bloomquist, well wide of the mark.
Well, and Coach Christofferson made mention of her when we were talking before the game, what a good player she is, and just a freshman.
Back in the Cardinal end, all the way to center ice for Del Castillo, plays it in, and the Cardinals will complete their line change. Puck skips off the skates of Karinic, able to regather it, chip it into the Cardinal end. Stopped up by Alyssa Hansen. Hansen skates to center, plays it in deep. Greg giving chase. Back behind the net by Gallus. Battle continues. And coming free with it is Jessica Dexheimer. Had that pass. Got through and a little two on one. Pass behind the back, but too far in front of Shea McLaren.
I think Shelat McLean was going to continue in a little bit, but and that one, as you mentioned, a little bit too far in front of her.
They call this one a hand pass, yeah. And face-off going to go all the way back down.
I don't know if I see.
Puck comes out to the point. Hanula is shot. That hits traffic. Recovering is Gallus along the boards. Chased by Fish. Plays it back behind for Dexheimer. Stopped up by Greg along the boards. Dexheimer back near side for Karenic. And ahead it goes to McLean into the zone, trying to drop. That shot by Springman deflected wide and into the corner. Del Castillo just plays it to the blue line, but kept in there. And then Brandy comes out and blocks that shot. Del Castillo will skate to center. Chipped off her stick. They'll skate back, dump it in. They'll complete their line change. Hanula. Hard off the near boards. Bailey Ryan. Skating into the zone. Plays it to center, but the only one there is Bazal. Bazal long pass. Nice touch to the middle. Here comes Canton. Shot by Westgaard, rather, is deflected into the corner off the toe. Brittany Buell. Played back to the Elk River end, and that'll be icing.
That was good to see Whitney Gregg back out on the ice. She did take that shot to the midsection in the second period, and I know Jim Diffley was working with her up behind the bench, but definitely nice to see her back out on the ice.
Hansen plays it up the boards. Del Castillo able to poke it out of the zone and all the way back to the Elk River end, and that is going to trickle just across the line and be icing again.
This is one thing I know Jessica Christofferson, head coach for the Cardinals, would like to avoid the action down the icing and the action down back in the Cardinal end with the way that Elk River is able to score goals.
Hansen will recover behind the net, spin away from Canton. Canton stays with her, nearly had the puck. Hansen loses her stick again. Tie up along the boards, Canton comes away with it, dumps it in deep behind the net. Hansen recovers, skates behind. Gets it ahead for Hackett. Hackett into the zone. Plays it around the defender to herself, trying to get it back out front to Brina, but that shot pass was deflected away. Hackett recovers behind the net, leaves it behind for Del Castillo. Up to the point. Lawrence, a quick shot, deflected in, and the save made by LaFontaine. Westgaard couldn't handle it. Shot is knocked down by Canton. Ryan steps up and stops the action just outside the blue line. Bazal, that pass gets out to center. Vizal ends up with the puck again. Vizal into the zone. Tipped away by Hinula. Back to Simon, whose shot is up over the cage. Simon recovers on the near boards. Tried to get it back behind for Williams. Recovering is Westgaard, his shot. And Buell makes the save and holds on for the faceoff.
Westgaard doing a nice job of trying to walk in there, and then the wrist shot right in the midsection of Brittany Buell. And gonna make sure she covered that one up. Kind of walking in towards the net and then pushes that one into the midsection of Buell.
Long shot from the point. Buell covers it up. And we'll try it again.
Well, after a little bit of time of Elk River not getting a shot on goal, two quick ones for the Elks.
Off the draw comes to Whitney Gregg, who races to center. Opportunity going to the backhand, and Buell closes the door as Williams came right in. Back out to the point. Westgaard is shot. Buell will hold on for another faceoff, and now we've seen Elk River really controlling the zone and putting some good pressure and getting some good scoring chances at the Coon Rapids end.
Well, that's what Coach Sager talked about when he chatted with us, is they have to do that. They have to control the zone. They have to get more opportunities and convert when they do get those opportunities there. Buell does a nice job staying with
Williams, using her speed to get around the corner. Pass deflects off the skates of Springman, back into the corner. Fish behind for Bloomquist. Reverses. That one is knocked down. Del Castillo, first one to the puck, races in one on one. Stops up, will take the shot, and an easy glove for LaFontaine on a shot that was probably going wide.
Well, Cardinals just want to do a better job of, like they did in the second period, of just pressuring in the Elk end. But credit Elk, the Elks, they've been doing a good job of taking the Cardinals out of what they were doing that was successful to them earlier.
Hinula able to break that up at center ice as the Elks trying to float some wingers and just spring and create some odd man rushes. Shane McLean out front. Williams couldn't handle it. Or Springman, rather. Off the boards. Hackett had it in her skates. Covered by Gallus, and she takes behind her own net. Gallus will skate to center. Move it ahead, skips away from Springman a little bit. Broken up. Kept in at the line, though, by Mitchell, who shoots wide. Springman plays it back in deep. Bloomquist turns it around. Hackett gets it out and gets off the ice. Broken up by Stahlberger. And she gets it to Bailey Ryan. Ryan gets to the red line, plays it in deep. Cardinals finish their line change as Gregg challenges behind the net. Bailey Ryan there as well. Coming out of the scrum, however, is Shay McLean. Her pass broken up and then played all the way down. And that'll be icing.
Well, Cardinals not generating much offense here in the third period so far. I think just the one shot on goal.
Hanson stopping things up on the far boards. Cardinals play it back in behind. Ryan jams at it, now recovers in the corner, trying to get it to Fish in the slot. Bouncing puck loose out front, and the Elks just play it the length of the ice. And that'll be icing. Close as you can get to putting it on net, just to avoid a dangerous situation, but it's off the side of the cage.
And you got to make sure, if you're Buell, just make sure it doesn't go towards the net to you. Play
this
it out,
one
off
is
the side.
Weird, bouncing around, and smart idea to just get it out.
Yep. Yeah, you're holding on to a slim 2-1 lead at Elk River, and you want to make
sure. And you know, everyone out there in a black jersey is well aware that their lead came off a really weird goal.
Yep.
and that, you know, maybe they don't deserve to have that lead. And as well as this game has been played on both sides, it would really be kind of sad if that turns out to be a winner.
Yeah, it would be, because that was a situation where 9 times out of 10, Brittany Buell sees that puck and able to keep it out of the net.
Fanula lays it ahead for Del Castillo. A little give and go. Del Castillo trying to get it back to her, broken up by Simon. Stahlberger back across, and here's Del Castillo with it again. Into the zone, leaves it off for Hackett. Hackett took herself out of his scoring angle and flips a little backhand in front. She gets it back, a little give and go try with Alyssa Hansen, but that was broken up. Simon has her pocket picked by Fish. And now skating with it is Allie Gallus. Gallus to center. Into the zone, leaves it off. Shot by Williams, easily saved by Buell. Under 8:30 remaining in the third period, and a glove save on the shot by Gallus.
Cardinals able to get a couple of shots on goal. Now again, lead the shots on goal, 16-15. No, it's just 16 all now.
Ryan ahead for Greg, trying to cut the corner to get around Gallus. Gallus couldn't clear. That shot deflected and went wide off the stick of Whitney Gregg. She recovers up front. Ryan, a shot just misses. Ryan back to the point. Blomqvist, his shot. That bounces around. Greg taps. Stahlberger can't get the angle. Plays it back out front. Greg can't get a stick on it. And smartly, Tiffany LaFontaine just dives on top of it.
Yeah, it was a good opportunity for Coon Rapids right there. Some looks in front of the net, and you saw Greg there in front could not get a handle on the puck. Otherwise, she may have an opportunity to score.
Elks race into the zone with numbers, but the puck knocked away off the stick of Kennedy Mitchell, and they turn it back the other way. Hanula into the Elk River zone, around the corner. Shoots it high off the mask, a rebound, and that net is gonna come off as LaFontaine spread eagle, trying to keep the crease covered.
Yeah, again, a fortunate situation. Coon Rapids coming out, playing hard and crashing to the net.
Well, an interesting and kind of a smart idea. She knew she had a little bit of room up there in the corner, but you know, went for that top shelf. It was closed, but it created a scoring chance out front off the rebound. Shot that deflected and nearly got past LaFontaine. Played out to center. Hansen stops it up. Hackett will play it back in. LaFontaine tips it to the corner. Up the board, Springman. Played in by Hackett. Karinick into the zone. Tipped off her stick. Back the other way, and Cardinals still battling for it, but if that puck's a little bit straighter up ice, they probably have a 2-on-1, if not a 2-on-0. Cardinals tried to break that up. Icing waved off. Left there, Fish plays it around to the near side. Recovered by Karinick. Up the boards, Bailey Ryan. That pass was behind Greg. And a foot race to the other end as Dexheimer gets there first. Dexheimer up the boards, Bailey Ryan. Fanned on the shot, pushes it toward the net. Taken away by Shea McClain. Brandy Del Castillo plays it behind Westgaard. Passes off the back of the skates of Springman. She'll try and track it down in the neutral zone and does. Carrying it into the zone. She's rubbed off it by Hanula, who recovers. Under 6 minutes remaining. Hanula trying to get around Canton. Into the zone. Dumps it in behind. Westgaard far side. Up the boards. Kept in by Brandy Del Castillo. Behind the net is Hackett. Working against Dexheimer. Dexheimer comes away with it. gets it ahead to Samantha Westgarden. This one's played all the way down. That'll be icing. We'll have a faceoff back in the Elk River end of the row of the goalkeeper, Tiffany LaFonte.
Joe, you know, the way Elk River started this period out, you thought they were going to really take control of this game. But the Cardinals did a good job of getting back into it and starting again to apply some pressure down in the Elk end.
Much like Coach Christofferson said, yep, during the first intermission, they weathered another storm.
Yep.
And now bringing a little bit better pressure. And they've had a couple good chances that they weren't able to bury, and a couple of weird ones that just didn't bounce their way. Canton in offside. That'll draw the whistle.
Yeah, with a 10-2 Elk River team coming in here, and granted, Coon Rapids playing well, but maybe with 5:20 left, wasn't sure if it would be a 2-1 advantage one way or the other at this point, but it's been a good hockey game.
Bozer wanted to play that off the boards into the zone, instead played it off a Cardinal player in the bench. That time she kept it down. Turned around by Bloomquist. Pass is broken up, played back in deep by Samantha Westgard. Hackett tied up along the boards with Canton, pokes it ahead to Stahlberger. Her pass broken up. The shot by Bozer right on, and Buell will hold on for a whistle.
Oh, smart play by Bozer, just put it in on net. See if something can happen on a rebound situation. You mentioned under 5 minutes remaining, 2-1 lead for Elk River. Cardinals giving the Elks all they can handle.
Ryan will play this one in deep. Pass doesn't click, but it does get out of the zone. Lawrence off the boards. That one stopped up by the official. Greg plays it in, a 2-on-1 opportunity. Puck comes out to Bailey Ryan, and a sliding save by Brianna Simon. Yeah, and wow.
That was a great play by Simon to get in the way, but she had to wait a little bit for that
Greg
puck as well.
Greg leaves it off for Fish. Back out front, hit a skate. Played off the boards and going the other way is Brianna Simon. Simon cuts across, broken up by Hanula. Ryan will take it off the boards, race to the zone, take that shot. It's deflected up high and gloved down by LaFontaine, who just leaves it for a defenseman. Stopped up at the blue line. Hackett can't get into the zone. Cross-ice pass broken up by Stahlberger. She marches in, top of the circles. Shot deflected high and wide. Recovered by Mitchell. Stopped up there. Brina Del Castillo races. Bizzal got there first. Hackett pressuring, able to get to the puck. Chips it behind for Del Castillo. Behind the net. Out to the point. That pass deflected. Bloomquist on the backhand, able to keep it in the zone. Will step up now. Trying to regain control. And the puck got away from her, and Elk River gonna ice this one. And we'll have another faceoff in the Elk zone. A little more than 3 minutes remaining. Still 2-1.
Well, again, Cardinals putting pressure down in the Elk end and doing what they need to do to get the equalizer. They're just not able to get a shot on net and make that happen.
And a timeout is going to be called here by Coon Rapids with 3:13 on the clock.
Now Coach Christofferson calls her squad over. Talk about things with, as you mentioned, 3:13 remaining, trailing by a goal.
Well, they've been so close. They have generated some scoring chances.
They have.
They have put the puck toward the net in hopes of getting one to bounce their way. It has not happened yet. But over the last 4 or 5 minutes, I would have to say that they've been the team, or the aggressors and the team in control.
Without a doubt, they have. And you know, you talk about that goal that went in to give them the lead. It's situation now. If that would have been stopped on a typical shot, we'd be sitting at 1-1 with 3:13 remaining. And Coach Sager talking to his squad as well about just making sure you maintain the lead. Don't give up anything in front of your net.
Tiffany LaFontaine looking at the faceoff dot to her left. Cardinals trying to keep it in. That one played too far ahead, and that's going to be another icing call, as that one was just over the stick of Raylan Korenick.
Well, the longer they keep it down in the ups end, the better it is, obviously, for Coon Rapids. Still plenty of time left to try and get that equalizer.
Anula is shot through traffic, still loose, poked at again, and ends up in the near corner. Elks just playing desperation mode at this point. They are just doing everything they can to play it long out of the zone, maybe create that race for the puck and a possible odd man rush, but quick to just try and get it out of their zone. Kept in there by Hanula. Bizzal will chase back into the corner, turned away from pressure, meets Brina Del Castillo there, hacking in there, digging for it as well.
The Cardinals just doing a nicer job of hustling to the puck and controlling the action.
Comes free, Hanula is shot, the save, rebound, and LaFontaine able to cover it up. 2:18 left.
Wow, big opportunity for the Cardinals there. With Madness in front of that net, you're going to see it come in, a nice shot on net. LaFontaine sees the puck bouncing in front of her, and she's able to fall on it, force that face off to her left.
Off the draw, puck in the corner, battle for it. Bailey Ryan comes back to the short side and tried to jam it home. Net wiggles but stays on the post. Hanson keeps it in at the blue line. That pass will get the Elks out of the zone. A two-on-one chance. The shot just right into Hanula. Ends up trickling into the far corner. Recovered there by Westgaard. Westgaard tied up with Fish. Greg can't get out past Julian Miller. Continues to battle for it. Cross ice by Hanula. Recovered off the boards by Bailey Ryan. Ryan turns in the corner. Tried to center. That was broken up. Another centering attempt stopped up. Get it back to Ryan. Skipped under her stick. Poked out to center by Gallus. Stahlberger plays it in. Hanson's shot misses wide. Tied up in the corner, Hackett comes away with it. Can't slip it through the feet of Canton. She'll just rip it off the glass and all the way down. It'll run out of steam, no it won't. And it will be icing, 1:01 to go. Brittany Buell still standing in her net.
Yeah,
and, Coach Mossy telling her to come out a ways and be ready to race for the bench. If they gain possession off the faceoff, they will pull the netminder. Stahlberger in the faceoff dot against Annie Dalton.
Officials coming over to the Elk bench and saying a few words.
Off the draw, Hanula. Her shot blocked. Buell was halfway to the bench, but here comes a breakaway attempt for Simon that missed wide. Hanula racing up the boards, got it out of the zone, recovered by Canton. Canton turns, dumps it toward the net, poked to the corner. Canton chops at it, comes free, the shot wide by Williams. Played in behind by Simon. Cardinals regain control under 30 seconds left. Del Castillo's pass didn't have anything on it. Hanson recovers in the corner. Cross ice pass picked off by Simon. Centering attempt was deflected off a skate. Westgaard will just dump it back in. Cardinals maybe one last chance with 10 seconds left. Anula's pass to Hackett, and she meets pressure. And
that's going to do it.
That is going to do it. The Elks are going to hang on for a 2-1 win.
Well, a tough way to lose a game, Joe, especially with the way they gave up that second goal. And it's a bittersweet pill here. Obviously, they want to get the win, but they did play well against a team coming in at 10-2. So that'll even up the Cardinals' record at 7-7. And the Elks will increase theirs to 11-2.
Yeah, and for the Cardinals, another one that they have to go into the locker room thinking, you know, this is one that we may have just let get away.
Yeah.
Too many of those in a 7-7 season.
Absolutely.
Thus far, about midway through the season, that, you know, they've been so close, and this one kind of an unfortunate bounce, a weird goal.
Weird goal.
That ends up being the winner.
Yeah, it really does. And the Cardinals are off for a little while. I believe they don't play until the 29th, which is that game that we're going to do.
We will be
there. A doubleheader.
We'll be there. Well, there it is on the 29th. We have a little time off coming up.
We do.
We've got girls basketball against Concordia Academy on Friday of this week, or of next week, I should say. The only game we'll do next week. And then on the 29th, that doubleheader, Coon Rapids against Minneapolis Southwest. What a beautiful thing. Cardinals and the Lakers.
Who would have thunk it?
I'm going to have to wear a purple shirt and a red tie.
I think you should. It won't look great, but you'll feel good.
And then later that evening, we'll have some girls hockey. Cardinals taking on Cambridge iSanity. But that's going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score from the Ice Center is Elk River 2, Coon Rapids 1. I want to thank everybody for joining us, continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. For the entire crew, it's been a Jeremy Millington production. With Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young, saying goodnight.